The basic goal of the 9th Summit of the Americas is to strengthen hemispheric solidarity, but the meeting of the leaders of OAS member states has failed to meet this objective, even before it got underway, observes NGP leader Andrew Decaires. Several countries have boycotted the gathering, including top officials from Mexico and three Central American countries, in protest of the decision taken by the Biden administration to not invite Cuba, Nicaragua, and Venezuela. Most CARICOM leaders are in attendance at the event, including St. Lucia's Prime Minister Philippe Pierre. The NGP last week had called on the Prime Minister to reconsider the invitation.
The National Green Party red flagged this particular event, just realizing that, you know, we have such great ties with Cuba and Antigua and St. Vincent, which are OECS fellow states, declined the invitation for those same reasons, and the fact that, you know, we are a regional body and that everybody should have been invited. But in America's arrogance and in their attempt to eliminate anybody who has a different sort of political system, they failed to invite Venezuela, Nicaragua, and Cuba, and other countries in the region took issue to that. As a result, the Mexican Prime Minister, President, did not attend as well. And there were actually low-level diplomatic missions were sent, and many of the leaders didn't attend. And so this is a failed summit.
The Biden administration has said it selected countries based upon the acceptance of political freedom, human rights, and democratic values. And that is why the three countries were not welcomed at the summit.
Mr. Pierre, knowing the person he is, who is a sort of, you know, not an aggressive, arrogant person, but a man with, you know, morals and values, felt that he should attend. And when he comes back, we'll find out what has been achieved. But obviously, the summit is a failure. And him going, I don't know if it was worth it or not. And we'll find out when he comes back.
The drama over the invitation list has dampened the prospect of major shows of unity. However, President Joe Biden remained intent on showing his commitment to a part of the world often overlooked in American foreign policy. At the launch of the summit, he called for cooperation and a renewed focus on democracy. He also announced a new economic partnership with countries in the Western Hemisphere as part of a broader effort to stabilize the region, reeling from the economic impacts of COVID-19 and the war in Ukraine. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.